timings where like you do something that people normally do much earlier, you do it a little bit later, and they're just not prepared at all.
Like a later Oracle or something.
Yeah, exactly. All right, guys, this is game number two, DRG versus Deer. In the bottom left, winning game number one, he is
Samsung Galaxy Deer.
And in the upper left, in the red,
Dongnaegu.
What's up, guys? Thank you for coming down to the studio. Those of you at home, you're always welcome to come down here and witness esports in the flesh.
I have a quick question for you. If Deer and his opponent here, if these two players had... Like, if they were commentating together, would they be Deer G or Deer Goo?
Oh, man. Now, here's a question for you. If we freeze you, are you in our Artosicle or in our Art Pop? Toast Pop. Yeah.
Artsicle.
Artosicle?
Artosicle. For sure.
Not a Toast Pop.
Yeah, if you were tofu that was hanging from a curtain, would you be Tasteless or Tassels?
Okay. Well, on this map, we're on a very it's very large. However, these two spawning locations on the left do put you in a little bit closer proximity. Also important to note, the mains, especially by air, are quite close to each other. So we may see some interesting games here. Zerg should just be expanding, hugging the top of the map, and trying to expand away from his opponent.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see what exactly Deer has in store for us. Generally speaking, unless Zerg does a timing, Zerg is just kind of deflecting and growing as Protoss is trying to outmaneuver them. So Deer might have to do some kind of interesting timing attack here.
Yeah, I actually really am liking this map for the PvZ matchup on both sides. It gets very interesting as they start really macroing up, like max supply, trying to get fifth bases. Because a lot of the game at that point, if no one's taking critical damage, is kind of maneuvering around these various hills, trying to get the best of your opponent, get them out of position, and then repositioning your defensive units, like for instance Lurkers having to run around and block wherever Protoss is trying to go in because it's a supply based defense. So definitely a really cool map, but it looks like Deer doesn't want to play a long game at all. He's getting an early twilight, and that almost always means very sharp timing attack.
Yep, and he's getting blink with that. Looks like the Overlord does spot this, so DRG should be privy to what's going on.
Yeah, that's a super quick blink. I wonder about this choice from Deer.
Let me talk about this, actually, because I got a lot to say with this. The fact that when you – first of all, you can get there very quickly, but also you could blink up into the main.
Yep.
No problem.
Absolutely.
You could actually really exploit your opponent
when
here.
You have the Mothership Core, it gets really annoying dealing with hitting the third and main base. That's a really good point.
And actually, it's a pretty long travel distance from the third to the main.
Yeah.
You got to make this full horseshoe maneuver around to get there. So this could be definitely something where Deer can just out finesse. And this is pretty cool. He's going to go in here for an Overlord assassination, and he just supply blocks him.
Yeah.
And that's actually pretty big because Warp Gate's finishing, and this does cause a hiccup in the production rate right now for DRG. For DRG.
He does lose a Stalker for it, and the Stalker's more expensive than Overlord, so I don't love it 100%, but it was cool.
Now, he might be able to come out here and actually save this if he gets if he sends the Stalkers out to try to help it. Mm. Nope, doesn't do that. Stays back, deciding it should be better to just hold on into your main.
Now, I definitely agree with what you said as far as this being a pretty good build for the map. The one thing I'm a little bit nervous about is quick blink attacks is the amount of times DRG has dealt with stuff like that is outstanding, right? Because this is a story as old as time. Okay, this build right here.
Yeah, very true.
So just throwing that out there that I think that DRG is going to be one of the Zergs that's going to be best against this type of play. But we'll see. Definitely it is quite an abusable location.
Okay, he picks up here. Kind of a cool little attack that we have coming out now. He's going to begin moving out, headed northbound over here. Now, let's see where exactly he attacks. You can see DRG completely identifies what's going on here. He's got spine crawlers in a very good location, out of range on the low ground.
Yeah.
So that if the stalkers do try to engage that, they have to blink up there, which means then they're stuck fighting the spines. Now, he could try to micro that pretty fancy with the warp prism, but even then, I think it's going to be a pretty futile attempt.
Seriously. Well, it looks like he does want to... Oh, he blinks forward immediately. Wow, that was a very sharp move right there. And in fact,
some corrosive vials
do end up hitting him here. So we'll lose a few stalkers. The Queen's actually pushing out back that prism pretty well. Loon's coming down now. This might be the time to blink in. Yeah.
Oh, wow. The corrosive vials are connecting. but it does not take out the warp prism.
Five hit points. Five.
Wow.
We need plus five versus shields from corrosive bile.
Well, I mean, the rush can continue as long as the warp prism's in the game. He might actually have to try just kicking in the front door, since DRG did invest in having defense over there in his main.
Yeah, I don't think he can kick in the front door, though.
I think you're right.
I think that this rush is almost held completely. I mean, blinking up to actually kill off the spines is a little bit scary because he doesn't see the full army here.
Right.
So this is, like, I like how DRG's placing his units. Doesn't necessarily have all of them there, so it makes it scary for Deer. There's a lot of unknowns here about where he wants to attack.
Yeah, and if you misstep when you're doing an attack like this, it will fail.
Mm.
I mean, Zerg basically has to try to hide some amount of information on what they have with defense. Whoa!
Got to be careful.
Yeah.
You don't want to hit your own lings with that.
Okay, he's going to come in here, try to get a surround. Nice job leaking over there onto the ramp. However, I think there's just too much. If the lings can get below this. Well, hold on. Zealot's now coming up here to help try to combat the lings.
He went too far up the hill there. Look at that. Very nice blink forward from Deer, realizing that DRG actually overextended there. He really does want to battle him off the creep. Off the creep, the blink stalker player here can absolutely win.
So, this push is continuing. We have there's another warp prism being made. It looks like he's just super committing to this, Artosis.
Yeah. He's not giving up. He's going to go ahead and drop four Zealots there. And in the meantime, he is actually attacking in. Now, this is not with any reinforcements because he's going into that main base.
Yeah.
See how DRG deals with it on the two fronts.
We don't know if that warp prism was killed off in the main either, by the way.
Yeah, not sure. I don't see drones dying, so that's definitely a positive for DRG.
Okay, we have to assume that War Prism died.
I think it did.
I think DRG is actually in good shape, but I think maybe Deer selected the wrong strategy to use in this.
It could be. It's not over quite yet, but as this roach speed comes up, that's going to be really, really nice for DRG. And don't forget, the longer this goes on, the more mineral patches are disappearing for Deer, whereas with DRG on 45 drones, he's not going to run out of minerals to mine for a very long time.
It's kind of funny how that works out, isn't it?
Yeah.
He can.
It's different from the old days. You can't max on two bases with this Deer.
Right. There's definitely an expiration date on the strat here. He has to make this work pretty quickly, or it's just not going to be enough. Unfortunately, corrosive bile is not connecting properly down there.
It's getting a little bit scary from Deer. He's really worked up a very strong amount of stalkers here. Where is that prism? It's right behind him. Okay, so he is warping in more units here. We have some zealots mixed in there as well. The corrosive bile is just never landing at this point, which is really important.
This is pretty big here. The warp in right now, hitting the main. This may be the straw that breaks the camel's back. The stalkers are coming in right now. There seem to be too many of them. Right now, DRG losing battles on two different fronts.
Yeah, this is really rough right now. Taking a ton of damage. All of his drones just dying here in the front. And GG.
All right, Deer handily takes it. I gotta say, I didn't think it was gonna work after the first few minutes.
Yeah.
But he just knew how to keep the pressure on.
I think one of the really critical moments was when DRG kind of started overextending up that little ramp. You can't lose any extra units here. Like, you have to have like a basically perfect defense. You have to stay on your creep and whatnot. And he just was not able to. That was really great pressure applied by Deer with the prism and everything. You can see Deer is just, he's in absolute top of the world shape because DRG is not playing poorly today.
No, he looks good. Deer just looks like exactly what we've seen from him in the past 2 months. A really scary, solid player. He's adapted very well here at Legacy of the Void. We are going to go to a short break when we come back our next match here in tonight's GSL Code S.
Times that I've seen you lose your way, you're not in control, and you won't be told. All I can do to keep you safe is hold you close. still you can breathe on your own. Till you can breathe on your own. Hold tight, you're slowly coming back to life. I've been giving you hell, I've been giving you hell, darling. Let go.
Try to move back.
Onjana, 있는 그대로의 맑고 깨끗함을 지켜가라고. 겨울을 잊은 강물이 내게 말했다. 맑고 깨끗한 칠성사이다.
새로운 영웅은 언제나 환영이야.
오버워치 5월 24일 출시. 예약 구매로 누구보다 빠르게 친구와 오픈 베타에 접속하세요.
이거 페이가 좀 늦게 끝나서.
아 그래요? 괜찮아요. 그냥 게임 몇 판 하면서 내려오고 있을게요.
아씨 뭐 하는 거야 아무도. 아 오라고 줘. 뭐 철 만들었나 부서지지도 않네.
웬열? 와 움직임이 끝내주는데.
아 진짜 부드럽게 움직이네.
플렉스볼은 굴곡진 덕선에도 막힘이 없거든.
발음 조심하자.
나 덕선이라 그랬냐? 턱선에도 막힘이 없다고. 저게 면도기로 가능한 거네.
역시 대세답네.
대세가 뭐야? 전세 같은 거?
요새 애들 다 쓰지?
그게 대세야.
그래가지고 내가 저거 쓰잖아.
그래서 나도 저거 쓰잖아.
선우는 뭐 쓰지?
보라 누나한테 물어봐.
태기는 뭐 써?
덕선... 너 나한테 왜 그러냐?
덕선이는 아직도 좋아. 야, 마이콜은 뭐 쓰냐?
2,500만 명이 응답한 플렉스볼. 아직도 안 써보셨나요? 질렛, 남자를 위한 최상의 선택.
케이스리의 지치지 않는 열정으로.
Passion is my fuel. The new K3.
신제품 브라운 시리즈 3를 소개합니다. 몇 번의 움직임만으로도 빠른 밀착 면도와 최적의 피부 편안함을 선사합니다. 전에 없던 빠른 속도를 경험하라. 신제품 브라운 시리즈 3. Only from Brown.
땀 타협하지 않기에 멈추지 않는다. 말이 아닌 땀으로 보여줄 것이다. 땀 흘리는 순간에 게토레. Gatorade.
지금 바로 요기요.
아내가 그치 김매니아인가?
세대 교체를 위한 립단 테스트가 시작된다.
이렇게 구우면 어때요? 기가 막히죠?
GF가 대세긴 한데 다음
우리가 한번 봅시다. 단장 양반 립단 테스트
크리스탈 하츠포 단경 지금 다운로드 받으세요.
피자 통 떡볶이 통 짬뽕 통 보쌈 통 대한민국 모든 배달음식 통을 응원합니다. 배달은 우리가 통이니까.
전설이들 당신의 이야기가 시작된다. 드래곤 아이드 지금 시작합니다.
내가 한마디만 할게요. 잘 들으세요. 제가 생각 많이 했는데 꼭 해야겠어요. 거짓말하는 거 아닌데 지금 중재 발표합니다.
찾을 수 있는데 일부러 안 잡고 보면 왼쪽으로 크게 돌아갔어요. 이렇게 됐다는 건 원정을 본인이 잡겠다는 거거든요.
네, 자 울트라 밸런 올라갑니다. 200대 200대로 싸움이에요.
신준
근데
구동조정 먼저
신준 잘 들어갔고 뒤쪽에는 유령.
근데 유령 꼭 괜찮게 싸웠어요.
자 뒤에 맨것이 옵니다. 위에 유령이 버텨주고 있고요.
계속 잘 싸웠어요.
자 맨날 남기죠. 유령 좀 차립니다.
시드로서 선언하겠습니다. 그날만큼은 제가 악마가 돼서
잘생기고 착하신 준호야. 주말에 족발집도 많이 갖고
좋아하는 느낌이 너무 좋아요.
평소에 정말 진정한 형이고
사랑해요. 복수하고 싶습니다.
구걸 하고 싶진 않고
수혜자는 한 명이기 때문에
바꾸는 거 저와 상관없다고 생각하고
조금의 저 걸리든 좀 쉬운 저 걸리든
올라갈 사람은 올라간다고 생각해요.
누구든 도발하면은 바로 저도 맞도발도 하고 이렇게 좀 재밌게 할 생각이니까 많이 기대해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
시즌 1 코드에서
GSL Codes. So far, Deer has managed to trump DRG in a pretty impressive 2-0 series.
Yeah, yeah. You can just see that Deer is like one of these guys that might win a league this year.
Yeah.
Whereas DRG, he is playing very well.
I think the big question is like, how long can DRG last? This is a tough group. A little bit more lopsided than some of our other groups, for sure.
Yeah, it's kind of tough because Deer and Sue are both guys. You're like, well, these guys can absolutely get round of eight.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
Hero, on the other hand, the hero formerly known as Liquid. You know, this guy, I really don't think can get out of the group, especially after that interview. He's nervous. This has been his MO for so long. But when he was winning while being nervous, he was just top of the world, right? So.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, the fact that he was managing to win with a considerable amount of anxiety is quite remarkable.
Mm. Well, I guess we'll just see how he does here. I want these old guys to come back and kick ass.
Yeah.
Really badly. I think it would be amazing.
Well, we have Zen State Sue over here.
Yeah.
breathe in, breathe out. And we have seen some players do stuff like this, like meditating or just completely relax themselves, releasing all negative energy.
It's definitely better than tensing up and getting too much adrenaline in your system and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, some players operate very differently from others. Some, they need to be relaxed. Others, actually, like Jadong was a good example, would get himself very amped.
Yeah, he actually was famous in StarCraft 1 for getting himself very angry during the matches.
Yeah, he would actually start, he would be cursing in his booth and talking about...
Like repeating to himself that he would kill his opponent inside the game, obviously.
Yeah.
So, I mean, everyone has their own different way of doing it, for sure. Not surprised that Sue kind of takes the more zen approach. That's kind of like the vibe you get from him.
Yeah,
anyways.
No, he's a very, like, cool, mellow guy.
Yeah. He's not, like, high strung or anything.
Doesn't, he takes it seriously, but not that seriously. You know what I mean? I guess is the best way you could put it. So let's see what happens here. Now, Hero has engineered some unbelievable strategies that we would only see from him. Sue is like the full package, okay?
Yeah,
this guy can do the cheeses. He can do the macro games.
Totally.
You pick the fight. He's probably the best at it out of all the Zergs there.
Dark,
another example as
Yeah. I mean, you're right. Full package, Zerg. We'll see. Can Hero do it?
I don't know. In the bottom right, in the blue, formerly on Team Liquid, he is
Hero.
And in the upper right, in the red, he is
SK Telecom T1 Sue.
So we already had one game with basically these positions already. I don't know if we're going to have the same game necessarily, but it's definitely something to keep your eye out for. It seems almost like Protoss just ought to do something like what Deer did in that last game.
I think it definitely in these spots can be very strong. It's hard to defend against both those locations.
Of course, there is some degree of predictability when it's so obvious that you can do that. Sometimes the Zerg can try to hard counter it. Sometimes even if they try to hard counter it, they can't hard counter it. And this is a lovely night out. Thank you guys for coming out.
The best date night you could look
for. The best date night ever.
Let's not forget another just little part of last game was where the third base was taken for DRG. You can actually expand your third to the place where he was wanting to take his fourth, right? Like,
right.
We could see Sue take his third to that more leftern
base. Artosis, why don't you just change your ID to Articulate, okay?
Articulosis!
Man, we got three bases here. And the pool's almost done.
By the way, look, he does go ahead and take that base. Now, a strategy like what we saw Deer do
wouldn't be as effective.
Infinitely less effective now. So, definitely, I think, a better choice from Sue taking this base.
Now, let's see. I feel like for Sue, he probably isn't going to go for any kind of timing. I think he just kind of sits back and produces and just tries to scout out what exactly Hero's doing and then just counter it.
I mean, I think what you do probably here is tech up towards lurkers and just kind of see what
just
your opponent's doing the whole time. It's, I mean, that's kind of like if you want to play the macro game, that's the unit that you're going
towards.
This
is something important to note in StarCraft. You don't have to go out and try to kill them with some kind of special attack. This is like a common concept people don't realize. You sometimes just have to get ahead and just keep that advantage.
Yeah.
And eventually the opposing side squanders all their resources and loses. So, you know, it's definitely a situation that Sue might try to play into.
Well,
I believe that is a parent or a relative of Hero.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So we
have dyed hair, and he has dyed hair. So I mean.
Clearly family. Yeah. So we have the Adept poking in. This is just a pressure Adept. This is not really to kill any drones.
Yeah.
Oh, my God, it is. Okay.
You can generally pick off a couple. Look at this forced mining time loss. So there's nice little things you can get done, and it gives you some intel as well. It's like, okay, speed is done, and now he's dead.
He loses that. Now, I was going to say, normally you don't have just if you're going to kill workers, it's usually two that go in there.
Yeah.
And not the one, because even though the Adept can like theoretically shade out, Zerg should also theoretically always have enough units to do the damage before the cooldown of the shade move is finished.
Totes.
Totes McGoats.
Well, we do have, actually, look at that. It goes Phoenix into an Oracle. That's kind of interesting because you get your Spores later against Phoenix play because they aren't going to really go after your drones till 3 or 4. So something like this, I mean, this is kind of a tricky, cool move that Hero's doing to open Phoenix into Oracle.
Yeah, it's we were talking about this earlier, like with the Nidus Swarm that was like a little bit later than you'd ever expect. We saw with DRG, kind of the same idea. If you see a Phoenix or two coming out, you kind of discard Oracle from the option list.
Yeah, and look, he doesn't
be available. He's just not ready for it, as you can see right here.
Yeah, he's really, this is like a very meta-type move that we're seeing from Hero.
It's very Hero.
And it's worked perfectly. Like, this was really, really brainy. This is the type of plays that you need to see out of Hero if he's going to win the game.
Yeah, for sure.
That's like, that was really well done. Look at this, he's making another Oracle. Three Adepts as well. Like, he can very easily take a third base now. There's no, like, no chance that any damage can come of him.
Now, as we've always seen with Hero, he has these really smart moves. Like, out of all the players I've casted, Hero is definitely up there in the moments where I go, oh, whoa, look at that. That's pretty sneaky. I like what you're doing there.
Yeah.
However, a lot of times Hero can't finish the deal. That's the problem.
Yeah.
He's like, you can see he's quirky. He's a really brainy guy. He's definitely sees the game in a very certain and correct way.
Mm-hmm.
But when it comes to these big late game decisions, he does tend to flounder.
Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, that definitely has been one of his issues. But hold on. Look at this. Two Oracles now flying in. There's no Spores up for Sue. I mean, right? Am I crazy? There's not really Spores. He's killing off Queens. He's going to run in here with the
I don't know about him attacking that
well,
extractor.
Yeah, I mean, there's I feel like he definitely could have gotten, like, infinity more damage done here. But, I mean, okay, he's doing a great job against Sue right now.
He might
now.
Have actually done it, by the way.
Yeah.
This is, like, so much damage. It's almost terrifying.
He got a lot of Queens. The thing is, like, there's no Spore there.
Now, the counterattack might work here. Lynx have speed, so.
You know, instead of killing two Queens, I would have liked to see him kill every drone at that expansion.
Exactly, yeah.
Because,
yeah.
I mean, it's great to kill Queens. It's fantastic. But killing every drone at a base is also fantastic.
Killing drones definitely slows them down a lot more.
Yeah. Now, they can have as much larva as they want if they have no money to spend it.
Yeah, exactly. We see the Lynx and Hydras coming up here. Now, let's see if he can actually hold this spot.
That's wonder if one Ling will run into that shortly.
Yeah.
sees that happening.
I right, see well. Sue a little bit apprehensive. There we go. He activates that. Sue a little bit apprehensive. He doesn't want to overextend here.
Mm-hmm.
He's going to see if he can't just get any extra workers. Now, you got to be careful because there are sentries here. He can actually, if he does it right, box us in and then punish.
Oh, and look at this. We actually have disruptors being made. Oh, and... Okay, like...
Okay. Okay.
Is...
There's a first time for
is
everything.
Is that better than killing five or
I don't
six
know.
Drones?
That's exactly what I was wondering. I guess it would depend on exactly how much energy you had there.
Well, he has at least 50, so that's enough to kill a lot of drones. But, all right, we do have a big attack actually coming in.
He is a dead man, and Artosis. This is it.
This could have been just... You know, this is kind of heartbreaking.
It's all indicative of what we've seen from Hero. He's, like, really smart, but then he just, you know.
He's trying to be a little bit too fancy. Ooh, that was a sick hit. He might actually hold now.
That was pretty nasty.
But, yeah, this is, like, the thing is, he didn't actually need disruptors this early. Like, it's just, like, a little bit too much of everything going on right now. Too many spinning plates for Hero.
Yeah.
This is a little bit heartbreaking. Like, just a bit too much fanciness, I think.
Yeah, I guess there's really no other way to say it. I mean, it's like everything he's doing is cool and it makes him look good until Sue puts together all the parts he was working on and finishes the puzzle.
Yeah.
You know?
There's some sort of, like, stability missing here to Hero.
I feel like this has sort of always been the Hero that we've cast.
It is.
There just seems to be, like, all right, you probably beat a lot of really good players.
Players have a fingerprint in StarCraft, man. Like, every player is different. You can tell them apart.
Each player is actually a unique snowflake.
Yeah.
There is definitely some kind of
for innovation.
Strategic and tactical DNA there. Yeah, no, except for innovation.
But,
also known as AlphaGo. Beta version, unfortunately.
Yeah, he was practicing too much Go, so didn't actually get into Code S. but no, I mean, this, like, God, I think the disruptors were too fast here. Like, if he wasn't trying to go disruptors and instead had some more gateway units, he would have held there.
Thing is, man, he could actually push him here. Zerk doesn't even just have to stay out here. I think he can actually just go forward.
Yeah, it's hard to attack up a hill, of course, but just keeping him off of third base is victory, even after the amount of damage that Hero's been able to do. Hero does not have charge. He's actually getting Blink right now, which is what you'll pair with Disruptors.
Now, the problem with the Lurkers here for Protoss is that they can't get out now without everybody absorbing damage. In fact, if he edges forward just even a little bit more, it's huge.
Ooh. All right, let's get that one. But now he's going to come up that the Disruptors are on cooldown. Push up there with his Lurkers.
Okay, so he's going to try to shove in here. And the problem is Protoss is basically going to lose all of these buildings. That is just going to happen. There's no way for Protoss to attack into that. Yes, he might send out a Disruptor, and then a Lurker will blow up, and it will look cool. But ultimately, this game will be over.
Yeah, it's just the fact that he doesn't have that third base. Like, if this was all happening at the third base instead, this is still a game.
If you look at it, all of his gateways are right here. He can't produce. There's just no way he can produce.
Yeah, very, very true.
GG, Sue takes game number one.
Ouch. Look, I think that there was a lot of really cool stuff that Hero did, but I think he definitely got too fancy here. Okay, yeah, you have adepts coming, and he targets down the queens, but he has two oracles against a mineral line that has only one queen guarding it. Those two oracles, every Protoss and Zerg, and even Terran in the world knows, can devastate every drone there before an oracle dies.
You could see he was multitasking so much, too, that even after he killed those queens, he was like having one oracle hit the extractor, which was like,
And it's like he's not necessarily micing what he should. Like, he has an idea of how this should go. Like, I'm okay with him throwing down the stasis ward behind because that takes, like, two clicks to do as opposed to if there's a queen there, you have to micro the oracle nonstop to get the drone kills.
Yeah.
So, like, that's fine. But, like, to go into disruptors that quickly off of, like, one immortal and not many gateway units, his macro fell behind a little bit.
It's like there's just this giant hole, which is that Zerg actually has enough to kill you. Even though you're doing all this damage, you forgot about the whole counterattack, basically.
Five,
anyways, guys, this is game number two, Hero versus Sue, in tonight's GSL Codex. Cross spots in the bottom left, in the blue. He is
Hero.
Looks a little bit nervous.
In the upper right, in the red, he is
SK Telecom T1 Zoo.
Definitely, though, you know, I especially like the Phoenix into Oracle mind game. And then, you know, Sue was like, ooh, that's a nice hat.
That is a good hat. Zerg support
there.
I
like that hat.
Don't let Hero see that hat.
Oh, you're a Zerg player.
Yeah.
What were you saying?
I especially liked his Phoenix into Oracle play. That was, like, really cool because Sue was super caught off guard by that.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah, it was all right.
It was okay, Artosis.
I don't know if I'm as excited as you, but I mean, it was good.
It wasn't that cool. Like. Okay. We have Protoss going for a quick expand, as is the Zerg.
Yeah. Nothing weird going on here quite yet. We're just going to have to StarCraft and chill for a bit.
Yeah.
See where this goes after that Cyber Core.
It's kind of funny when you cast Sue's games because it's not like there's one thing that really sticks out. It's just that he's kind of doing everything right. Sometimes the very best Zerg players can in some ways be the least exciting.
Sometimes. Some of these players, like Sue's fingerprint is not as different as, like, let's say Dark's. Like, Dark has a very specific style, right?
Like
he likes Corruptors more than other Zergs.
Yeah.
You know, he very much likes to get a bunch of roaches, stuff like that. Sue, on the other hand, is so flexible. I mean, he used to be, before he got really good, like, more on the aggressive side, and that's always the way I looked at him, but he's really kind of just everything now.
You know what he is? He's like the guy that melted his fingerprints off so the police couldn't find him. Okay?
You're saying he works for the Men in Black.
That's right. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Agent S.
That's right. Agent Sue. So, yeah, I mean, it's just, it's kind of hard to distinguish his style so much because he's, like I said, he's just kind of doing everything right. He's just basically doing a good job. Sometimes the most powerful aspects of StarCraft can be, you know, the least wowing in a sense. You know, you're just like, wow, he just seems to have a lot of stuff.
Like, yeah.
He definitely made the right number of drones there.
In fact, that last game kind of shows one of the ways he's so good because, like, he took some damage early on and
he got deceived.
A lot of things threw him off a little bit, but it didn't really throw him off. He just like kind of collected his stuff that he was building, like you said, moved across the map and did as well as he could.
He clearly had played the game more properly. Like Heroes, you know, it's like a bunch of magic tricks or something, you know. He's like pulling a coin out of your ear and making the ping pong ball disappear, but then Sue's like, magic is not real.
Yeah.
And then Hero just disappears.
Oh, poor Hero.
He's like, you're just a bunch of, you know, shadows and mirrors, man.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's kind of what happened there.
I'm going to make your third base disappear.
I'm going to make you disappear out of Kodas.
Yeah.
But first, I will saw this nerd in half and know it's not a trick.
Ah! All right. So
I just rewatched that that movie, Prestige.
Oh, yeah?
That's great, man. Good movie.
Yeah, I watched it a really long time ago.
It's good, man.
Yeah? I gotta watch some good movies. Gotta do that. Get on that.
We gotta go see... wait, have you seen Deadpool?
Yeah, I saw
that. Oh, damn it. Okay, I was gonna ask
Did you
go with me. Not yet, no.
Oh.
No, sorry. I've been casting too much. I haven't had time.
It's good. It's worth watching.
Okay.
Yeah.
I will do it. I will go.
It's not one of those super unbelievably corny cringe.
Well, I think
superhero
from what I understand correctly, it's like making fun of superhero movies, which is great.
It's kind of like Guardians of the Galaxy. I actually heard it was made by the same guy.
It was, yeah.
And that's insanely smart because that guy makes the best movies for superheroes.
Yeah.
Everything else is so corny. Like when I watch the Avengers, I'm like, why am I in here?
Oh no!
Why
I
am I in here?
I watch the Avengers.
I'm 32
and I'm like,
years
well,
old. What am I doing?
That is 2 hours.
Because
of my
I like
life.
Superheroes.
I can never have back.
Yeah. Yeah,
okay.
But that is like true garbage.
Yeah.
Like it is just so
it's
cringe.
True garbage.
True garbage. Like, I mean, come on. Just so corny. I'm like, oh.
Well, we have once again a Phoenix opening here. Now, this is not one where he, you know, transitioned into a quick Oracle. He's just going for a much more traditional kind of bread and butter Protoss style. He's making Phoenixes. He's getting Immortals back at home. He's developing that unit composition to be in a good position later on.
Yeah, and he's taking a very quick third base with this, so that's really good. His economy's looking nice. Not as much probe production as you would think, I guess. But, oh, he's actually walling in those other rocks. That's interesting. We don't really see many people do that.
Yeah, that is interesting. I guess it makes sense, though. And he can have the Mothership Core kind of orbit between these two locations.
It kind of, like, slows everything down from getting him, I guess. I mean, eventually he'll probably lose those two gateways and those two pylons, but that's not the biggest deal if that's actually slowing your opponent so that you can be in a good position. Oh, what is this? Is this drop?
I guess so. It's kind of weird that he's doing that, considering that we had Phoenixes.
Oh, yeah. It's just like kind of randomly going out into the map right now. Like, was that supposed to be an Overseer, or is this you did want it to be a drop? I guess.
Well, let's see if he tries to use it. Like, it could be one of those awkward moments where he accidentally made it, and he knows he's on TV, so now he has to act like he meant to do it, and then he's going to lose the game. But you know, people at least think he's some kind of
kind
of strategy that was really good that we'll never see.
He has a small group of speedlings. This is what's happening. He's going to run. He's going to just do a small speedling drop, which is cool. I like moves like that.
Phoenix is coming up now. They pick up the queen. The Hydras are coming down here to defend, but the queen will be taken out in the nick of time there.
And looks like he will go ahead and get this speeding drop underway. Not sure how much damage it's really going to end up doing.
Again, kind of a peculiar pick here to go for this. I just, you know, expect it from a guy that's got Phoenixes out here.
I guess if you have 8 speedlings, this is, like, not a terrible thing to
you
try.
You just want to try to use them somehow?
Yeah, it's... I mean, I guess it didn't really do that much.
It did less than anything, really.
Yeah,
it cost him.
8 speedlings would have been better out in the map, you're right.
Yeah.
Like, I like people trying to use drops more, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So
well,
I appreciate
drop games are always exciting,
I appreciate the effort, Sue. Thank you. It's like if you did some Burrowed Banelings. I'm like, yes, I want to see more of those as well.
I approve. Phoenix is going to come over here. You can always shave off the drones, usually, if they have a spore. Just get the ones on the gas.
Yeah, you need 2 spore to block the gases from...
And, of course, then you're losing another drone, in a sense. Yeah. Good job. Gets the queen.
Yeah, it forces those Hydras back, actually. That's really annoying. By the way, the creep spread, not too good. A lot of that having to do, of course, with these Phoenixes kind of being on top of picking off everything and forcing Queens to play a little bit safer. Does see this Lurker down. He's actually maybe even going to see it finish, so it's going to have a very good idea of when he's going to see Lurkers.
Queen lives. He's got to be careful, man. He's actually going to lose these now.
Yeah.
These are actually trapped over here. Oh, no!
So they're pretty screwed. One Phoenix left.
All right, guys. One of the tenets of StarCraft.
Oh, two Phoenix.
You need to keep the Phoenixes alive for pretty much the whole game.
You do. At least he has two. One is the loneliest at number least that Phoenixes ever do.
Oh, yeah. But, that's when the Phoenix can just pick something up. He can maybe delay a drone from making a hatch until he runs out of energy.
The sound of one Phoenix clapping.
Yes.
Okay, so this is a lot of Lurkers. He's adding in Lings. He has Hydras with it as well. We have Charge done. Storm is almost done. And he's been making some Immortals, but he doesn't really have that many Immortals. So this is a little bit tricky. And he's actually... Okay, he is coming out to meet it. This is the most important part. You can't let Lurkers get into position in front of a base.
But what you want to do is you want to move out, and then as they burrow, move back. You want to force them to sink into a position, and then try to regroup.
All right, well, you know, I guess he's picking off a lot of Lings with those pylon cannons.
And as we see the Phoenix over there, it does beg the age-old question, if one Phoenix is on the map and picks up a Ling, does it make a difference?
It does not.
It does not,
the
no.
answer to that yes. one. Well, we actually do have a nice warping coming up, but it's actually like so far away from anything that that could be a little bit of an issue.
You know, he might just be able to get in there.
Look, this is a great position right now that he's in. Sue, right? Because he's got his Lurkers burned in such a way, like he gets to rotate back and forth between these two entrances. And it's hard to actually break out of here. You have to go through like a small choke. If Sue's in front of it, you can't go through it.
Yeah, it's just really tough for Protoss to actually get out of this.
Yeah.
Keep in mind, he's also got these Hydras to try to get... God, that did a lot of damage. He's got these Hydras to try to gun down an Observer or anything like that if it does come out. I don't know why he's not using this.
He does start to. Now, this is really, really important. This is the one window for Hero to be able to win this game. When you force units to get drawn back with your Warp Prism,
that's when you break the contain.
You have to do this against Lurker contains. You have to do a Warp Prism move. And either your Warp Prism does a lot of damage or they send some units back. And that's going to be when you have possibly more units to, you know, to break through with. And he's killed 15 drones, so that's pretty good. All right, more charge lots going out the side. Maybe going to go and try to snipe that. Ooh, that's a great tag right there.
Yeah. Now, can he break it, though? Because the Lurkers are getting to a number where it's...
It's scary,
it's
man.
Actually, like, almost too much.
Seriously.
See if he tries to leap forward here with the Hydras and take out the Warp Prism. Doesn't look like he was paying that much attention there.
Ooh, this
Zealots is... Zealots coming in over here. This could be pretty big. I don't know where he warped those in at, by the way.
Those walked all the way from his third base.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, Sue actually doesn't have great vision on the left-hand side of the map. A little bit of a mistake there by Sue. Obviously, Hero's harassing him a lot, so it's hard to do that. But look at this. These Warpins are doing a great job. Okay, now we actually have Sue withdrawing with some of his units. This is the moment where you have to break him. You have to do it.
Here we go. Storm's blanketing down, beginning to take out these Lurkers.
He doesn't have that many Immortals. This is making it very, very tough for him, but he has some very good Psy Storms going down.
The best Psy Storms you could ask for, basically. But this is really important that Protoss actually breaks this.
Yeah.
Because otherwise Protoss is never going to get another base. And it looks like the harass is done, which means everything's going to head southbound, regroup back at that contain. Then ultimately, Hero is, I think, just going to run out of money.
He's dead now. All the units are coming back. Like,
yeah.
That was his one chance. I definitely have, like, a lot to say about this game once we see Hero GG out of it. But, you know... He definitely got some good harassment done and stuff. He had a lot of great ideas in the game. I think the execution against this was a little bit off, and the build order was a little bit off as well.
Yeah, again, it's just a story of Hero. It's like he's you can tell he's good, but it, like, he doesn't have all the working parts to force a win.
Yeah.
And it's now 147 supply to just about 100, a little bit over 100 right now. And, you know, all that Sue has to do, Sue doesn't actually have to go kill him. He just has to wait it out, and then Hero runs out of money.
Yes, exactly. And, like, he can continue to poke and even be cost-efficient here as well.
The cybernetics core is so annoying.
Yeah, it is. That actually takes a pretty long time to rebuild.
Yeah.
thing is, mostly Zealots are going to be built anyways here. But the economy of Hero is crippled right now. And there's no way for him to break out anymore.
Even to remake this, it's more minerals spent just trying to get back to the complete tech tree. So, I mean, this is just... This should be over. I don't know if he's not going to necessarily die here, but we're just seeing Sue slowly chip away at Hero, and pretty soon I don't think there's going to be anything left.
Yeah, look at this. A 4 Zealot Brass could do a little bit, but you know he can just kill that with whatever's coming out of his hatcheries at this moment. Sue's just like tightening the noose, basically.
Yeah, pretty much.
We're just waiting for Hero to tap out at this point.
Nice storms blanketing down here as he's going to keep inching in here with these Hydras. And they can pretty much always trade effectively unless they're stormed too hard.
Yeah. But there's nothing really left here. He's mostly out of energy. Oh, a couple of TTs.
You know
in. That's kind of nice.
Let's see if this can do enough. Even if this does a lot, though, I think the problem is that the Zerg still has too much over here at the front.
Yeah,
he gets the Nexus, beats me to it.
If you kill three of his bases and the other one is completely fine. Like, Sue probably just wins with what he has on the ground right now. Like, if he pushes into that third base, there's too much.
Hold on a second here. Protoss is trying to expand over here to the center left. Now, if he can get that up and get that mining, maybe he can do something. I'm just getting a little bit worried because Sue's actually carving his way in here. He might be able to get into the main and then just kill all the tech.
Yeah, yeah. Well, he's kind of going towards this third base right now. Isn't going to want to go in there quite yet. Does go up towards maybe the main? No. Some storm flanks could be nice.
Oh. Okay, he's going to come up here. This is really bad.
He actually didn't have energy for storms.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Just got it right there. That's rough. Hate it when that happens.
Okay, I think this is checkmate, guys.
Yeah.
Stuff in the Protoss main is pretty important. Now, granted, Sue did this with a sparse income here. That's it. GG. Sue handily takes 2 games off of Hero, moving him into the winner's match.
Yeah. You know, there was definitely some great harassment there. I would be remiss if I didn't point out that I think one of the big mistakes for Hero was the lack of the second robotics. Normally, you're going to grab a second robo before charge.
Yeah,
so that you
true.
Have enough immortals so that when you're harassing the prism, you can break through the lurker contain.
Yeah.
We saw you only had 4 immortals and you just barely could not break out.
Well, that does it. Not too much else to say about that. Sue is just clearly the better RTS player. We're going to go to a short break when we come back. Our winner's match for today's group here in the GSL Code S. Yeah, ihr macht es mir echt einfach. Hiermit bedanke ich mich bei euch, dass ich so leicht hab. Ich weiß alles über jeden ohne List, denn da steckt ein Teil bei Exhibitionist. Stasi könnte von mir lernen. Gegen Servers gebt ihr eure Daten gerne. Man hätte sich die Finger wund geleckt, eure Daten auf dem Silbertablett. Ihr seid die brave neue Welt, ja. Ich mach euer Leben zu Geld, ja.
Mr. V, it's yours. Yeah, and right now we want y'all to move back.
Onjena, 있는 그대로의 맑고 깨끗함을 지켜가라고. 겨울을 잊은 강물이 내게 말했다. 맑고 깨끗한 칠성사이다.
비트에 몸을 맡겨라!
영웅은 언제나 환영이야.
오버워치 5월 24일 출시. 예약 구매로 누구보다 빠르게 친구와 오픈 베타에 접속하세요.
한마디만 할게요. 잘 들으세요. 내가 생각 많이 했는데 꼭 해야겠어요. 거짓말하는 거 아닌데 지금 중재 발표합니다.
시드로서 선언하겠습니다. 그날만큼은 제가 악마가 돼서
잘생기고 착하신 준호야. 주말에 족발집도 많이 하고
좋아해요. 느낌이 너무 좋아요.
평소에 정말 진정한 형이고
사랑해요.
복수하고 싶습니다.
구걸 하고 싶진 않고
수혜자는 한 명이기 때문에
바꾸는 거 저와 상관없다고 생각하고
죽음에 저 걸리든 죽음에 저 걸리든
올라갈 사람은 올라간다고 생각해요.
누구든 도발하면은 바로 저도 맞도발도 하고 이렇게 또 재밌게 할 생각이니까 많이 기대해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
6 GSM Season 1 Quarters.
This is Size Generation. 2016 핫
6 Season 1.
Welcome back to the GSL Codas. We're finally going to a match that should be really good.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I think that Hero was playing like pretty well. Had some Hero flaws. DRG was playing pretty well. But Deer and Sue, definitely much better matched here.
Okay, now who do you think takes this?
I'm think
leaning
Deer.
Towards Deer.
I think Deer, but if
but
Sue
I
took it, I wouldn't be like,
yeah,
I wouldn't be like, whoa!
Well, that's the thing, right? Because Sue, I feel like we kind of count him out when we talk about the very, very best of the best because, like I was saying, his playstyle isn't exactly that exciting. It's just so solid.
Yeah.
If he's going to go for an aggressive build, he does it basically perfectly. Not flashy, but perfectly. He'll always balance workers versus attacking units when he's doing his production. But Deer just looks really, really good.
Yeah, he's doing fantastically right now overall, you know, killing it in Pro League, doing a good job here so far, looked absolutely awesome against DRG. Sue, like, just kind of fell off after all those second places.
Yeah, it's also a different expansion, right? I mean, he was dominating in Heart of the Swarm.
Mm-hmm.
So let's see what exactly he does this time around. Now, Sue could just move on.
Yeah.
It's even possible, to be frank, that Sue is in the finals again in this GSL.
It is definitely a possibility.
Yeah. I feel like we're kind of ignoring him a little bit.
Yeah, we are.
When we've talked about the other players in this, he's not somebody like TY where everybody's saying, oh, my God, this guy is just too good.
Yeah, definitely.
But, yeah, anything could happen here.
And,
Deer against us.
It oftentimes does, Tasteless.
Yo, man, we have so many upsets. It's always crazy how the landscape of who's good is changing here at the GSL.
Yeah. Well, Sue versus Deer, you think it'll be a 2-1 or 2-0?
I think it's 2-1 no matter what.
Oh, really? Okay.
I just can't imagine these guys not taking games off of each other.
Yeah, it could be. It could be.
I want it to be a 2-1. I don't want this to be a whole day of just 2-0s, you know?
No, certainly not.
All right, so we're going to start this day off with this match off with on Ruins of Sierras.
Yeah, it's you know, this map definitely gives us a lot of interesting games. Sue, as we even saw just against Hero in that last match.
Yeah.
Won't be dying at anything like that blink on. Like, he did not take that base that we saw DRG take. I'm sure Deer was watching that series very carefully to see if he could pick anything up. And these two cools a cucumber, but it looks like that StarCraft 2 sign is nervous as can be.
That's his energy. That's the energy coming off of Deer right now.
Wow. He really exudes it. Look at him.
That's right.
He looks just pumped.
We are in game number one. The winner gets one of the last two remaining spots in the round of 16 in the GSL Codas. In the upper right in the blue, in cross spots in this game, he is
Samsung Galaxy Deer.
And the crowd goes wild.
Good crowd today, too.
Yeah, got a lot of people down here. Thank you guys for coming down. We love you. In the bottom left in the red, he is
SK Telecom T1.
Tasteless, how you doing? Buddy, you got to speak for yourself. I just met this crowd. I mean, I really like them. I'm enjoying this. I want to see where it goes tonight, but
I'm a passionate man. I fall head over heels.
You're very
love
cheap,
the crowd.
Is what you are. Like, Tasis will love you. I mean, if you clap when he announces a name, he's like, "Oh, I love you."
I love you.
I'm like, Nick. Oh my God.
I'm too easy,
I'll marry you, crowd. I'm like, no, Nick. You just met him tonight. Okay.
You gotta slow down.
Alpha Sue.
So we got to talk about the AlphaGo thing that's going on.
Dude,
if you guys missed out on this, there has been a supercomputer made by Google called AlphaGo, and it has been playing the board game Go. If you're not familiar with that game, you've probably seen it before. It's like a brown background with the white dots and the black dots. It kind of makes me hungry for some Smarties when I see it.
Mm-hmm.
And so far, against the best player in Korea, AlphaGo is up 2-0. The next match is going to be tomorrow.
He's basically, from what I've read, the best player of the last 10 years, although a Chinese guy has kind of crushed him this year, apparently. So the Chinese guy might actually be the best, but this guy is right up there, okay?
He's good enough that this is like a good measurement of man versus machine.
And the game is like way harder to program for than something like chess. It's actually like there's a lot more different moves than chess. But anyways, it's one of the most exciting, interesting things. I've never seen Go before, but I'm really excited. I'm going to buy a Go board, and you and me are
going
to play.
We're going. We're going to do it, man.
Yeah, I'm going to write.